So the question was, how can we get rid of the database just for the sake of these tests? And the answer is, simulate the database. We'll create a class that looks like the class we want to simulate. But instead of doing complex tasks like going to the database, the simulation will just do simple, fake things, like returning a list of invoices that are in the memory with no need for a database. And actually, simulating a database can be quite interesting from the test automation perspective. After all, simulations are faster than the real implementation. Going to the database is quite slow. And we also have more control on the simulation, because some things are just too hard to do in practice. For example, to test whether our program behaves correctly when the database crashes. How would you do that? Turn off the database and execute your tests? With a simulation, we can simply say, please crash, and then the simulation will crash. This simulation in software testing, we call it a mock object. So when we say we are going to mock some object, we are saying we're going to create a simulation of a specific class just for the sake of testability. And you can see that in practice, we do apply mock objects in a lot of cases. For example, when we are dealing with an external system like a database or a web service or whatever other infrastructure you have. Or if you want to simulate exceptions that are hard to simulate in the real system. Or when we are dealing with third-party libraries that we don't control and we need to simulate them. So these are very good reasons to apply mock objects. And in practice, how it works? We have our production class. In this example, the invoice filter. And in this invoice filter, it currently instantiates the data access object. Of course, this data access object goes to the database, and that's what we want to avoid. So instead of really using the real data access object implementation we have, we are going to tell the invoice filter to use a simulation. A mocked one, so to say. However, mocks never know what to do unless you teach them. So we are responsible to set the expected behavior of this mock. Or in other words, to teach what this mock needs to do when some of its methods are invoked. For example, in this particular test we are writing, we should teach the mock to return a list with two invoices when the method all is involved. So this is the idea of a mock object. But how do we make our class under test to use mock? How can we create mocks, actually? And how can we teach the mock to do what we want to do? When it goes to the source code, it gets easier to understand. And that's what we are going to see in the next video.